A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th August. Actually, 14th August was the date my father-in-law expired. He was hospitalized for last 1 month and I have not been able to cover current affairs, but we'll cover the backlog. So this on this page you have center sets the ball rolling for Jammu and Kashmir polls. Election Commission holds fresh meetings on delimitation exercise under new Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act. So this is regarding Jammu and Kashmir. We have seen how Article 370 and Article 35A have been annulled for the state, which has now become a union territory, bifurcated into two parts, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. The union territory of Jammu and Kashmir would have its own legislative body, so elections have to be held, and Election Commission had its first meeting for delimitation exercise necessitated under the new Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act. Then on page 7 you have here state to ask for 6800 crore aid. So this is the state government of Maharashtra. A cabinet subcommittee has agreed to use the corpus which it has for now, but it will ask for aid from the central government to rebuild four flood ravaged areas in western Maharashtra and Konkan. So here you can see the wish list of the state government for various losses which have been incurred because of the floods, crop damage, road repairs to the families, small traders, irrigation works, cleaning, loss of livestock, etc. On page 9 you have 57.3% allopathic practitioners not qualified. So this is what the health ministry has said. Chief ministers of all states have been asked to take appropriate action. So here the ministry says that rural patients are at risk given the high density of doctors in urban areas and India's poor doctor population ratio of 1 for 1,566 people. So World Health Organization standard is of 1 doctor per 1,000 people. So this issue is being discussed here. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is deliberate, don't disrupt. So this is regarding how legislators, they could do well by adhering to the model code of conduct. So, you know, lawmakers, they organize disruption of legislative business. So this is being spoken against here. And the second editorial, war within war. So this is regarding the Saudi-led coalition war in Yemen. So it says as the coalition crumbles, Yemen needs a nationwide ceasefire. And the lead article is the contours of the Kashmir move. So this is again regarding India's action in Jammu and Kashmir. It is unilateral action. So this, it says, is enabled by the unilateralism in global politics and a decline in multilateral arrangements. So it's overall declining scenario which is, you know, discussed here. And this is writing out a clean bill on health. So this talks about how medical education needs continuous reforms, and National Medical Commission Bill, which is being proposed, it says could be the first step towards this. So National Medical Commission Bill seeks to replace Indian Medical Council Act. So it has to be passed by both the houses. So now it has been enacted. Then on the upper page you have, despite stagnant incomes and increased joblessness, Indians are hopeful about the economy's future. So there is a slowdown which is evident now in the country. On page 12 you have Election Commission kicks off delimitation process. So the 2011 census would form the basis of redrawing constituencies in seven extra seats. So internal discussions on delimitation of constituencies have been taking place. This was the front page news also for Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory. So that is detailed out here, you can see. On page 13 you have enact security regime for NRC data, says Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has directed Assam National Register of Citizens Authorities to enact a security regime akin to the Aadhaar data protection before making the information on exclusions and inclusions in the NRC list available to the center, government of Assam and Registrar General of India. So protection of data is important, just like Aadhaar. Is what the government, what the Supreme Court has asked the for the Assam's NRC data. On international page you have US delays tariffs on some Chinese goods, drops others. So duty on cell phones, laptops will be effective from December 15, but it is delaying tariffs as such because it was to be effective now, but it has been delayed till December. And also on some imports from China, it has dropped the tariff charges, which were proposed to be increased. Then, this is Saudi UAE rift weakens fight against common foe. So, this is what the editorial is also about regarding the civil war in Yemen. The Saudi-led coalition is fighting a war here in Yemen against Houthi rebels. But then, in this Saudi-led coalition, there is a rift between Saudi Arabia and UAE. So, this is causing the war against a common enemy, Yemen, being weakened. So, Houthis control vast swaths of Yemen. On business page, you have GST Council may discuss rate cut for auto. So, debate on lower tax for certain vehicles and input tax credit for premium housing on an agenda for the GST Council meeting, which will be chaired by Finance Minister as representation from all states. Then this is regarding a private sector bank. So one point which you should know is RBI norms for private sector banks mandate that promoters cut stake to 15%. So that is said, this is about retail inflation for the month of July. It is at same at 3.15%. This is CPI, consumer price index based inflation. And this is RBI issues final norms for regulatory sandbox. So, financial technology companies, fintechs should highlight existing gap is what is being stated. So, this is final framework for regulatory sandbox. So, regulatory sandbox means it's a sandbox, means it would be kept away from external environment to see how it works, how the regulation works. So, this regulatory sandbox is to enable innovations in the financial technology space. So, norms for that have been finalized by RBI. You can see a regulatory sandbox usually refers to live testing of new products or services in a controlled test regulatory environment for which regulators may permit certain regulatory relaxations for the limited purpose of testing. On page 17, you have auto sales fall 19% in July, worst in 19 years. So sales across segments in automobile sector have fallen, and this is the biggest slump seen since the one seen in December 2000 of 21.8%. And this is government issues norms for 1 lakh crore partial guarantee scheme for non-banking finance companies. So public sector banks can now buy high rated assets of financially sound NBFCs. So public sector banks can now purchase high rated pooled assets of financially sound NBFCs. So these include even housing finance companies, which came under stress recently because of the IL, which all started with the ILNFS crisis. ILNFS is a consortium group of NBFCs, and this crisis occurred in September 2018. So since then, the NBFC sector has been in stress, and now central government has issued guidelines for this partial guarantee scheme, 1 lakh crore partial guarantee scheme. So these are the important headlines. The last page has sports news. For detailed coverage of current affairs, full PDFs will be uploaded on the website as such too. Thank you. And sorry for the inconvenience which has been caused with the delay in current affairs, but we'll be covering that up as soon as possible. Thank you.